the day of salvation, have I so called thee. He said, behold, now is the accepted time.
Praise the Lord, beloved. What a joy it is to welcome you to another moment of empowerment by the word and quickening by the spirit. God actually has you on his mind. We're glad you have made it another time of encounter and another time of fellowship. As we get into God's word, today is a very powerful time. We're going to have a powerful time with God because God has been thinking of you. God actually has you on his mind. We have a special word from the Lord for you. I want you to open your heart and begin to receive what God will be passing across to you, because the word will take you from where you are to where you ought to be. I'm not alone. My wife is with me, and together we shall be bringing you God's word. Woman of God, welcome to Empowerment by the Word.
Praise the Lord, beloved. I welcome you to this great edition. This is a great edition. I want you to pick up your phone, call your friend, tell them something is happening tonight. I tell you, when you hear what God has on his mind for you today, you'll begin to enjoy, you begin to rejoice, because I know that your story is changing today. Hallelujah. Welcome to Empowerment by the Word. Praise God.
Hallelujah. I'm excited about this season. You know, we have a wonderful season that God has created. This is our turnaround season. Amen. Yeah, annually we have this program that God enabled us to put together. God commanded us to put together. Amen. God said we should always hold this program at this season, because I remember there's a scripture in John chapter number 5, verse 1. There's a pool called the pool of Bethesda. The Bible says at certain season, the angel comes to trouble the water. Amen. And when the water is trouble, whosoever jumps in after the water has been troubled is made whole of whatsoever disease they had, whatever issue they had. The God turns it around. God fix it at that time. So our turnaround season is just like the pool of Bethesda. God comes around to turn things around. And you know, every turnaround is as a result of God being around.
Hallelujah.
So during the turnaround conference, God comes around. I've never seen anything like that. You know, the scripture says, blessed be the God of Israel, would only do it wondrous things. Yeah. When God comes around, the wonders that God does is mind-blowing. Amazing. From inception. You know, we don't do anything except God commanded it. Amen. And whatever God commands stands fast. The Bible says, he spake, it was done. He commanded and he stood fast. When God commands a thing, he backs it up with signs and wonders, with diverse miracles. We have had testimonies upon testimony concerning the turnaround conference. You know, the turnaround conference, you remember when God first gave us the word concerning the turnaround conference at this time, that is always in February. God said at the beginning of the year, after we have waited on the Lord, we have fasted, God says we need to build an altar of turnaround for him, where he comes to. You know, the altar is the place where God meets with you.
Right.
He said, build me an altar there, I will meet with you and I will bless you there.
Amen.
So God comes to bless us on the altar of turnaround. You know, when God first spoke, you know, many years ago, and God, when you know, in every, when we came to the United States, God said, look, there are territorial spirits in every nation, in every city, wherever you go, there are spirits that are ruling over those territories. You need to be able to understand the spirits that are ruling over territory so that you can deal with them. As children of God, we have dominion over such spirit. But you need to understand the spirit, you know, and God opened us to three spirits, three territorial spirits, majorly that are predominant, that is over this country, America. A lot of people have not come to the understanding of that, but God opened us up to this territorial spirit. And because we have understood those territorial spirits and we are able to deal with them, during the turnaround conference, on the altar of turnaround, God comes to judge whatever is against the progress of his people. God comes to deal with it. So, you know, we have had mind-blowing testimony. Those spirits, we're going to be looking at those spirits tonight.
Amen.
And we're going to see how God uses those things to turn things around. The first spirit, I mean, as it is very hot in my heart. Now, let me just open us up to this. The first spirit is the spirit of the taskmaster.
Mm.
This is a wicked spirit. It's a spirit that is predominant over this nation. The spirit of the taskmaster is the spirit that will make you want to work more. The more you work, you think, okay, I need to work more so that I can get more pay. And the more I work, if I get more pay, I will be free. But you find out that people keep working and working and working, two jobs, three jobs, many hours, and the bills keep showing up. And they are wondering, why am I not free? Why am I not enjoying the liberty that I desire in spite of the work that I'm doing? It's like the more you walk, the less you understand. The more you walk, the less you get. What is operational is the spirit of taskmaster. That spirit is found in Exodus chapter number 5. Let's look, read verse 19. Let us see how this spirit operates, because God is opening somebody to something today that will bring about their liberty.
Amen. And the officers of the children of Israel did see that they were in an evil case. After it was said, you shall not minimize earth from your bricks of your daily task.
You shall not. You see, they were in an evil case because a lot of people are such, oh my God, the devil is a wicked devil. A lot of people are in an evil case. The more you walk, you think, okay, if I walk now more, let me walk more this month, then I'll be able to walk less next month. But the bills keep showing up. The needs keep accumulating because there's a spirit called the spirit of the taskmaster. It makes work is good. Work is good. Oh yes, God is the one that created work, but we should not be enslaved by work. But that is the spirit, because the taskmaster here will continue to give them more work, thinking that, okay, because I'm idle. Look at the scripture here. Look at Exodus chapter 5 verse 17. It said, but he said, you are idle. You are idle. Therefore, you say, let us go and sacrifice to the Lord. You know, you say, okay, if I'm idle, that is why I'm not breaking through. I'm not working enough. That is why I'm not getting the breakthrough that I need. It's the spirit of taskmaster. So he gives people the pressure to work more, and thinking that the more I work, the more I will be free. But it doesn't always happen that way. There's a spirit that's what to do on that altar. God deals with that spirit.
We are inviting you to come join the man of God for our life-changing worship services. We are conveniently located at 2435 Dixie Avenue in Smyrna, Georgia, off of Windy Hill. We have two powerful services on Sunday at 9:30 a.m. and our second service is at 11:15 a.m. Our Wednesday miracle service and Bible study is at 7:30 p.m. And thank God for Friday, because we have our intercessory prayer meeting at 7:30 p.m. We'll see you there in Jesus' name.
You know, we had a testimony. We have had diverse testimonies during this turnaround conference. We had a testimony the last time one of the sisters was testifying just after the turnaround conference. She's been working to be able to keep her bills going, pay her rent, pay her mortgage, and where she was living, pay the rent, and she was working more. And after the turnaround conference, when she came to the altar of turnaround, we had the testimony. She walked, she opened her heart, and the revelation of God entered her spirit. After just the week after the turnaround, the person that was her landlord, I think it was her landlady, called her and said, look, the down payment you have made for this house, I'm going to give it to you, and I'm also going to give you some privileges in that house where you are living in, so that you can be a part owner of that house. Amen. Because that spirit of taskmaster was broken, because that was what she was fighting to keep her home, to keep her property. And God just worked miraculously. You know, there was another person, you gave a word and you said, people should bring the picture of their relative to stand in gap and put it on the altar of turnaround. And somebody got a mind-blowing job. You remember that?
Amen. I remember that. It was one of the sisters in the church. She said her sister's husband lost his job. And they were all worried. And they have children. They have family and all that. And I just said to them, stand in gap for him. Bring his picture, bring his prayer request. Let's lay it on the altar of sacrifice and watch God move on your behalf. Barely 2 weeks after that, he got a mind-blowing job in a great organization. He became like one of the executives in the organization.
My God.
He got a job, he got a car to go with a job.
And he got the figures we are talking about is a six figure. It was earning like the vice president of the organization.
That's
that
right.
Was from zero to hero.
Amen.
You know, the scripture says, when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream.
Amen.
After the turnaround, you know, God just turned things around. It takes people from the ground to the highest level.
Amen.
You know, you can't explain God. It's a supernatural God. Our God is a miracle working God.
Hallelujah.
You know, there are some people that came after the Katrina. That was I think one of the turnaround conference we had during the Katrina. I know many can remember. They came, they were down to zero. But when you are up, when you are down to nothing, God comes up to something. God
Amen.
Came and turned their captivity around. God just began to open door. They got miracle houses, got miracle cars. God just turned things around. We have diverse testimonies, because that is just one of the spirit of the taskmaster.
Right.
That is one spirit that has held a lot of people down. But during the turnaround conference, God turns things around. I mean, let us be able to invite God's people. Listen, we have so much to share. There is nothing like being there by yourself. You need to come and be part of what God is doing to partake, because God has you on his mind. We can't wrap it up. That is why it's a 3 days program starting on Friday through Sunday. And it's from the 25th to 27th. You want to give people invitation because the fire is burning already. Amen. God is ready Amen. To do things that like he has never done before.
Amen. I don't want you to miss this date. February 25th, February 26th, February 27th, 2011. Friend, wherever you are, make out these 3 days to come and encounter the God of turnaround. And I can assure you by the mercies of God that God is going to show up concerning your case. If you are sick in your body, come. God is going to heal you. If you're in a financial mess, come. God is going to turn it around. Whatsoever the situation is, come and encounter the God of turnaround. February 25th to the 27th, God will be waiting for you. Amen.
The information are there on the screen. You can go to our website. Make sure you make plans. It starts next Friday.
That's right.
My God, turnaround is around the corner.
Amen.
It's on Friday, from Friday through Sunday, because this is the moment of encounter. You see, I want to give you a special invitation. Whatever you are doing, set out this time for God. You know, that's what the Spirit does. The Spirit doesn't have people. He says, why was the spirit of taskmaster enslaving the people? Because they said they want to go and serve God. So one of the things that the Spirit does is to make sure that you don't have time for God.
Right.
You don't have time for the ways of God. You need to tap into the supernatural. A lot of people are locked up in the natural, but God is a supernatural God. God can take you from where you are to where you ought to be. This is one conference. This is not a hype. This is the power of God. This is the move of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This is the glory of God. God will always create a time and a season. Our God is a God of times and seasons. God is a God of places. God, every time God wants to help his people, he creates an opportunity for the people. This is one opportunity that God has given to this nation. I know that you might be hearing it for the first time, and some of you have been here over and over again. You have your testimony to call. Don't come alone. Call your friends, call your neighbor, call your colleagues. The information are there on your screen. Go to the website. Give us a call. Let us agree with you. God will be doing extraordinary things during this turnaround conference. Those three spirits are dealt with. The power of God is released. Miracles are given. Breakthrough. In fact, we can't stop testifying. I've never seen anything like that before.
Yes.
One of the turnaround, the woman came. She has been on the wheelchair for 10 years. God lifted her up by the Spirit of God.
Yes.
She began to walk. Things began to happen. I mean, people buy cars. People buy houses. In fact, the Bible says when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion,
yes,
we were like them that dreamed.
Amen.
Then was our mouth filled with laughter,
yes,
and our tongue with singing.
Amen.
Then said they among the heading, the Lord has done great things for them. Whereof we are glad. God has done great things for us. God is about to do great things for you, believer. Beloved, come and join us. Come and be part of what God is doing. Before we go, we want to pray for you because, oh yes, you need to be sensitive. We want to pray for you in the name of Jesus. That whatever your needs are, give us a call. We shall be praying for you. The prayer lines will be open right now. Give us a call. Let us agree with you. Call for the information concerning your need. Whatever those needs are, it shall be done.
Amen.
Remember that Jesus is Lord.
Where do I go?